Hi, I'm Nick Schell. We're going through the lyrics of my songs that I've written and posted on this channel. At any point you hear a title of a song that you want to check out, you just type in the search box on my channel for Nick Schell, type in original song, and then the name of the title that I happen to say. And you can hear me perform the song. We're going to go through these lyrics and determine if I have a red pill perspective on life, on pretty much everything. And we're looking back on songs that I've already written before I really started talking much about red pill, because I didn't start talking about that till the very end of 2020. So here's a song, and this is like, what, the fourth video in this series by this point? I'm just gonna keep going. This was a song I wrote in June of 2020 about my son growing up, and I cried almost every time I performed this song, practicing it, the whole time I wrote it. Like, when you watch the video, that's like one of the only times I didn't like bawl, like break out crying, just bawling. So I was very emotionally affected by this song. Here we go. That boy's been growing up. That boy's been growing up on me. He shouldn't be old enough. He shouldn't be old enough. It doesn't seem. Those Hot Wheels have all raced away like the friends of Thomas the Train. And now I'm missing that boy who went with them. He's growing up. Those stuffed animals all used to be real, but they've started to all disappear. And now my baby boy, my firstborn bundle of joy, he's growing up on me. That boy's a part of me. That boy's a part of me. My son is growing up. I'm holding on to memories. I'm never letting go of these. My son is growing up. It takes so much for me to ever cry these days. So it's funny how these words are wet from tears. A father's love for his son is all it takes to get me here, and now I'm here. And I'm almost here now. Like, my voice is starting to crack a little bit, and there were dried tears on this page as I wrote this. Like, that was like the most emotional I've been consistently, like, in a long time, because as I've gotten older, I don't assign emotion to most things anymore. Most things we assign emotions to don't deserve it. You have to find the few things in life that do deserve emotional value, and then you express that emotion. And this was a breakthrough for me personally to write the song and experience that. So for me, that's very red pill. Red pill is not that you don't have emotions, it's that you only use them when they matter. And my love for my son is definitely one of those. Here's a song called We All Need Therapy. This is my red pill response to how people were dealing to coronavirus 3 months into. This is from June 26th of 2020. You can check out the song called We All Need Therapy. Here it is. We all need therapy, but it ain't free. So everybody finds a thing that gets them through the week. We all need therapy based on what we've seen. Oh, that's not the actual lyrics. That was actually a draft. Sorry about that. Okay, here's the real lyrics, I think. We're all in this together is all we know to say so far. If I could make you feel better, I'd make this all go away and start over. Start over like it never happened at all. We all need therapy. Everything's so tense. No hugs allowed anymore, but it's okay to protest. We all need therapy, but it ain't free, so everybody finds a thing that gets them through the week. We all need therapy. We've all seen too much. There's no real solution here, so fear becomes the crutch. We all need therapy. In these uncertain times, truth over facts, and a news feed filled with lies. That's so libertarian right there. And there's like some jokes in there, if you get the jokes. Talking about fear being sold on the newsstands and all that. Who's gonna save us? It's time for Jesus. He should be back any minute now. So let me know if you see him coming down in the clouds. There you go. A Christian, libertarian, red pill perspective to COVID culture. All right, what else have we got here looking through? So, now here's the song I wrote for my daughter. If she's a princess, I'm a king. You can check that out, that I wrote in July of 2020. Never thought I'd be the king of anything or live in a castle married to a queen. It never seemed that that would be my reality, but I met a girl who changed everything. Those blue eyes are still a mystery, and when she smiles at me, it's all I really need. Well, I'm a king if she's a princess, a slumber party in an Elsa dress, the proudest ever ballerina, the blondest ever senorita. Well, I'm the beast and she's the beauty. An interruption to my routine. She's always happy when she sees me. I am royalty, believe me. If she's a princess, I'm a king. My midlife crisis came a little soon, an existential view with doom and gloom, thinking, what's the point? What am I here to do? But I met a girl who changed everything. Those blue eyes are still a mystery. And when she smiles at me, it's all that I really need. By the way, in addition to being able to go on the search box and type in original song and then type in the title, like in this instance, if she's a princess, I'm a king. You can also type in song meaning, or I'm sorry, behind the song. and the title. And then you can see a video where I break down exactly what the meaning of all the lyrics were. Okay, so now moving on. A month later, the end of July of last year, 2020, I wrote a song about my wife. And here it is, called Her Photo Doesn't Do Her Justice. So let's see if this is red pill. Her photo doesn't do her justice. Yeah, it does. Okay. Her photo never does her justice. Never captures that light the way she looks in real life. No filter and she's gorgeous. I tell her all the time, a California beauty queen is all that I see. That girl is beautiful. It's undeniable. But if it comes from me, it's a lie. She'll probably take your word over mine. See, there's humor in there. That's part of my whole list of 10 things. You gotta be funny. I tell her every morning. She don't believe me. She stands in front of the mirror. It deceives her. If she wore a paper bag, she'd still be a model. I wish my words convinced her every so often. So if you see her, you better tell her yourself. Maybe she just needs stronger lenses in her eye contacts or in her pair of glasses. Maybe she don't hear me when I'm speaking. Maybe I'm just a figment of my own imagination. So if you see her, you better tell her yourself. It's like I'm speaking in Spanish and she listens in French. Who can translate this in English so the confusion will end? She don't believe me. She don't believe me. No, she don't. For me, there was just so much humor in that song. Like, man, I'm proud of how funny that song was. All right, what else we got here? Moving on to some biblical songs here. Ecclesiastes. One of my favorite books of the Bible. I went through, took lots of notes, my favorite parts of that entire book in the Old Testament of the Bible. Or if you're Jewish, that's just your regular Bible. And I wanted to write a song about it. I've always loved that book. And it's very red pill. So here's the lyrics. Ecclesiastes. Look this up on my channel. Go then, eat your bread in happiness, drink your wine with a cheerful heart, for God has approved your works. Enjoy your life with the woman whom you love all the days of your fleeting life, which he has given you under the sun, for this is your reward and your toil. All the rivers flow, yet the sea is not full. I set my mind in no wisdom until I realized this is the same as striving after wind. In much wisdom there is grief as the downside. Increasing knowledge is increasing pain. Nothing is better than a man happy in his activities. That is his lot, that is his destiny. For who will bring him to see what happens when he's gone? For God has so worked that men shall fear him till the end. I have seen the task which God has given the sons of men, with which to occupy themselves. He set eternity in their hearts. God remains a mystery even till the end. So there you go, that's a very red pill. But what's funny is I really didn't write that. I literally just took from the book in the Bible and pieced it together like a puzzle. So I wrote it, but those words are ancient, thousands of years old. But it is very red pill. We still got time for a little bit more. Going on to October of 2020, Get to the Point. That's the song, so look it up, Get to the Point. There's no such thing as a long story short, only a poor communicator. There's no need to say, well, anyways, I don't need to know these pointless details. I don't have to put myself through this. I'm afraid you've lost my interest. Your choice of narrative is simply not the best. I take pride in managing my time, which is why this is goodbye. So that's a fun song. I love that one. And although, yeah, I'm in control of my life, my time, my energy, my emotions. Here's one called Nostalgic for the Present, which, man, is just a theme of my life at this point, as I'm months away from turning 40. But this was written on October 5th of 2020. Life is a gift and time is all we have. I'm nostalgic for the present like it's the past. These days feel so long, but the years go by so fast. I'm nostalgic for the present like it's the past. It's like I'm in a movie where I get to the end, then I get to live my life again. By the second time around, I've got it all figured out, how to make each moment count. If time is a currency, then the dollar is down. And I can never buy back what is sold. I've lived a good life and I've got more to go. I'll die trying to hold on. Man, one of the things I'm proudest about in my life are these songs, because this is my life. And so few people hear these lyrics, hear these songs. And again, that's the irony. I make money off of the videos that I make. And in those videos, I talk about stuff I don't care about at all. And these songs are 100% my heart, but yet people don't value these songs. So I don't make money from these songs. People don't really watch those videos. That's irony, and I think it speaks to what these songs are all about anyway. You know, as far as, you know, your treasure is where your heart is. I've become a popular YouTuber based on talking about silly stuff that means nothing to me. That's what actually generates income for me. Yet these songs, which I pour so much of my heart and time into, hardly anybody sees them and appreciates them. But it's still absolutely worth my time. I'm understanding myself better through these lyrics. I guess I got at least one more video in this series. Look for it, and we'll cover the rest of the songs.